I believe that I have surveyed the whole Church of God, and I know something of church history and the developments of the work of God through the years, and I believe I know something of the Scripture, and I'm in a position, I think, wisely to tell you these two things. One of them is, I've said, the restoration of the vision of the Most High God. You see, we have too low a view of God now, and that is why the church has such a low place. The church rises or falls altogether depending upon her view of God. If she takes a high view of God, her people are inclined to be reverent and worshipful and solemn and grave. If she takes a low view of God, they become funny and flippant and foolish and live worldly lives and give up to the flesh. If she takes a high view of God, she simplifies her church services immediately. If she takes a low view of God, she has to drag in every kind of theatrical truck in order to keep her people coming. It depends upon her view of God. The old Presbyterians used to have such a high and noble view of God. What is the chief end of man? To glorify God and enjoy Him forever. And many of that school of thought held high views of God. Brethren, do you know the result of that? The result of that is that generation after generation, following generation, they stayed true to the faith. But when, as soon as we take a low view of God, and get to thinking of God cheaply, as they think of Him now, cheaply, that God is a pal, or that He's my partner, or that He's the big Joe upstairs, or that He's call Him by some other name, a living doll, one girl said He was. Well, now, as long as we think about God like that, we've never seen God. Imagine Moses trembling in the fire and smoke on Mount Sinai, referring to God in any other way than in awful, solemn terms. What we need in the United States is a revelation of what the philosopher called the mysterium tremendum, the tremendous mystery, and what the Bible calls Jehovah, high and lifted up. And Isaiah saw Him with His train filling the temple. The trouble with you, dear young people, and God knows I love you, as I've told you before. I do. I love young people. I love the twinkle in their eye. I love their little giggles. And I love everything about kids. I love youth. And I don't like the word youth at all, but I love young people. I love them, but they're being cheated in this awful hour in which we live. They've never seen God. And they've never seen very many people that have. And so you poor kids are victims of an elder generation that never saw God. And so they've had to teach you to crash and drag in every kind of claptrap to try to keep you happy. And if you tell me the truth, you don't respect them for it. You go along with it, but you don't respect them for it. My brethren, we need to see God again.